So the first one we're going to go to is the duty zone. So we're going to click, you have to actually click on the document to open it up. And here's the duty zone. And so now it's asking us to select a person, or we may need to add a person. Okay. So I'm actually going to go back out of here because we want to assign who in here would like to receive these documents to see what it looks like so that they can see what their clients are going to see. So I'm going to add you as the sellers. You would, Julie? Okay. So I'm going to put Julie in here. Here we go. So I'm going to add your name. Okay, so Julie Gunn is actually already in here because she has a role as an agent. Okay, so I'm going to click on here, and this actually has your email already attached. But now I'm going to give you a role. You're not the listing agent. You are actually the seller. Okay, I'm going to click send intro email because I want you to receive that. And I want you to get used to sending that to your clients, so that they can see what it looks like, okay? So I'm clicking you and adding you as a person. So now Julie Gunn, it tells you here, Julie Gunn has been added to this loop. So now we're gonna go back to duties owed. And we're going to select a seller. And you can see that Julie's already on here because we had assigned her and it knows that she is the seller. So we're gonna assign that to her. And now you can see if you go down here that it's assigned her initials to the boxes where she's going to need to sign. And it's assigned her name as well at the bottom where she's going to have to sign. All right. So we're going to go up here and we're going to fill in this section, which we're going to put the real estate licensee. And I'm acting for Julie Gunn. And the broker is, and the company is, okay. So now, if I wanted to just send this directly to Julie, there's more documents, right? There's like four documents I need to send. But if I needed to send this to her right away, then I would click save and share. And just so you know, no one can see any of the documents that are in here unless you share it with them, okay? So we assign several people to loops sometimes. We talked about all those people that we assign. Simply because you've sent them a document and shared it with them, it doesn't mean that they can see any other documents in the file, okay? So people are only going to see what you have actually allowed them to see or shared with them. So I'm going to send this to Julie. I'm going to save and share. And it says here that this is where it's going. This is Julie, and she can sign it. Okay, she has the authority. That's what she's going to do. And I'm going to click share. And now it says this document has been shared. So I'm done with this. I'm going to go back. And you'll notice in the loop section here where the documents are, what does it say next to the duties owed? It's waiting on Julie to sign it. Now, once Julie gets it and signs it, she's going to sign it and she's going to send it back. And this will change from waiting on others to signed. And remember in the beginning when we said that you will receive a notification if someone signed a document, you tell the system you want it to, you will have received an email or an alert on your phone that tells you she signed the document, it's in the loop. Okay, so there's the duties owed. So the other document we had here was the KW all-inclusive disclosure. And so let's open that up by clicking on it. We're gonna open it up. And we're gonna assign the seller, which is Julie. Okay, so you'll notice it auto-populated the address. And it's also auto-populated all of the spots that she needs to initial and sign, okay? So those are already done for you. So we're going to just make sure everything is, it looks kosher, okay? We're gonna save it and share it. and it's going to go to Julie and she can sign it. We're going to click share, and now that document is gone to her. Okay? You can do it that way, one at a time. Or if you want to share, once you've gone through and checked every document and make sure that all the information is correct, you can actually click on all of them. I can click on all three of these and click share. And it will actually send all of those documents to her at one time. So you can send one at a time, or you can send many at a time. And that's just what this little box is for. A lot of people click on this thinking it's going to take them into the document. It doesn't. That's just the click box to how many documents you want to share with the client at one time. Okay? Does that make sense? Okay. So you'll notice here that these are all waiting on others. And you'll notice how this tells you how many people the document has been shared with. Okay? You can also, if there's any messages that are attached to that, because your client has the ability to send you a message on this going, I don't know where to sign, or this isn't complete, or something is wrong, okay? You can also send a message to your client that will get there the same time as the email does saying, please sign all three documents and return to me as soon as possible. The other thing is really important is we talked about in the folder how you can have more than one folder inside each of these loops, okay? So if we go over here, you'll notice I can do a drop down, and I'm gonna rename this folder. And I'm gonna rename this Listing Documents. Okay, so this is the folder that contains all of the listing documents. All right.